Well, I read a story from Mark Farrell from MarketWatch. It just came out. He said, I have it someplace, I have it up on the chalkboard. He said that there are 20 things now, a global debt time bomb, 20 global debt time bombs that could go off at any time and change the world. I have another list for you. I'm going to show you next week of the people who hold the debt. I'm going to show you in the next few days 35 ways where everything comes undone. Now, I'm not saying that this is going to happen, but I'm asking you today to just listen to the stats. Look at these things and ask yourself, what are the odds? What are the odds? And then you decide. And this is what you need to decide. Do I need to do anything in my own life? Should I save more money? Should I not buy that big screen? Should I continue to listen to those in Washington on both sides of the aisle who say, we're past the storm? Here they are, the 20 budget time bombs, deficit time bombs. First one, federal budget deficit bomb. You think that's going to get any better? We just raised the debt ceiling to $14.3 trillion. We just did that. Give you some perspective. This is 2010. In 2005, 5 years ago, it was 7.8. America's debt will be 84% of GDP. It will soon pass, and I don't even understand this yet. I'm trying to catch up and learn about this. A toxic 90% trigger point. They say 90% of debt, and you're in real trouble. We're at 84% now, debt to GDP. Then there's the U.S. foreign trade bomb. $400 billion in trade deficits added every single year. Foreigners now own $2.5 trillion of our stuff. China is holding over $1.3 trillion in treasury debt. Then you have the weakening U.S. dollar and foreign reserve. This is their gold. Everybody has our dollar in their banks, all the countries. If they replace our dollar with anything else as their main foreign reserves, our dollar is over overnight. Everybody said this was crazy 3 years ago. I said it's coming. They're now saying within 5 years it could happen. I think it's a lot faster than that. Cheap money bomb, credit ratings down and rates up. What that means is we're piling all these dollars out. The debt is climbing. Our banks are falling. Well, somebody's going to say, it works just like it does at your house. I want a higher interest rate. A higher interest rate. How do you pay for all this debt with a higher interest rate? Global real estate bomb. This isn't even over. It hadn't even started. Commercial real estate bubble is now $1.7 trillion. $1.7, bigger than the housing bubble. This one I love because I'm just going to erase this one. This is the peak oil and the population bomb. The reason why I'm erasing this one is because this one is reported by the United Nations. And the United Nations is the one saying that, we're not going to have any snow in Washington, D.C. anymore, so I'm not going to listen to them. The next one is a Social Security bomb. This one's big. This one's real. They've been telling us it for a while. They say that by 2035, Social Security is going to go haywire. Did you see the story? What was it, last week? First time in history, we're in the red. Check your calendar. I don't think it's 2035 yet. Unless we're on military time. Will politicians cut the benefits of Social Security? They're weasels. Will they raise taxes we can't afford to pay? What do you think they're going to do with that? Then there's Medicare. This one is a nuclear bomb. This one I love. Republican progressive prescription drug benefit added an unfunded $8.1 trillion. Now, what are we doing? We're going to expand this healthcare. No. In the healthcare bill, they're going to cover 30 million other Americans just to take care of this one. The healthcare insurance bomb. The burden increasingly has shifted to employees. Costs are rising faster than inflation. Then you have state and local government budget bombs. This one I love. Deficits of $110 billion in 2010, $178 billion in 2011, on top of the more than $450 billion in underfunded state and municipal employee pension funds. Gee, firefighters. Who's going to pay for all this? Who's going to pay for it? Then there's the underfunded corporate pension bonds. $409 billion deficit in underfunded pensions. The consumer debt bomb, our TVs. Americans are still living beyond their means. Even with a downturn, we're still spending more than we have. Which leads me to this. This is good news. The personal savings bond. This is great. We're saving more. But 70% of our economy is based on spending. So this is simultaneously bad news. How about the war and military defense deficit? Iraq, Afghanistan, do you really think we're out of this? $200 billion annually, $3 trillion minimum is what they're projecting now. $3 trillion for military and war? Does this start to sound like Russia to you, the former Soviet Union? The homeland insecurity bomb, security costs are skyrocketing. The Fed Treasury bailout bombs, you think we're done? The government has shifted the burden of failing businesses to those businesses, to you. The American taxpayer, who do you think is going to pay for this? And this, and this, and this, and this? You are. How about the Washington lobbyists? Andy Stern, the unions, Goldman Sachs. They're deciding the future of our country, not you. The shadow banking derivatives bond. I love this one. Nobody's talking about this. $670 trillion. This is like Vegas, man. This is highly leveraged casino gambling. To put this into perspective, $600 trillion. If I take all of the GDP of all nations on planet Earth, how much is it? You see a problem? The dysfunctional two-party political bomb. How long is that going to work? Parties choose politics over the good of the country. Progressives continue to infect both parties and thwart the Constitution. Which leads me to number 20. The coming populist rebellion bomb. This one I love. Because those in the media are going to tell you it's the Tea Parties.